Mahler's Fourth Symphony starts with the bells, but playing them is not as easy as it seems. This is an original horse bridle. It's quite clear and it has a dark texture. It just happened to be here only for Mahler. So this is a very specific instrument which we use for the symphony. And we are very happy to have that. For us as percussionists, it's wonderful to play Mahler. So you are using in the symphony a bass drum, cymbals, we have tom-tom, the glockenspiel, sleigh bells and triangle, and especially the sleigh bells is a very, very unique instrument in this symphony. Most of the small instruments are just located behind us. We have a little secret place where we hide our instruments, and of course we have the studio for the bigger instruments. It's very handy because if a conductor asks for another instrument, we can easily walk behind, and in a blink of an eye, we are back with the proper instrument, at least most of the times. Cymbals, bells, snare drums, we have a huge collection of snare drums, triangles, tambourines, all what one person can imagine. In Mahler's music, the percussion is very versatile, and he's using it in a context which has never been done before. He elevates the role of the percussion. He just gives a description, very refined description, but only in musical terms or his ideas. So we can take as an example the cowbells. He explicitly says how it should be played. The hammer, which represents, many people can argue, but the blow of fate. And of course, the bells in Mahler's Fourth Symphony, which it all comes down, of course, to ideas. But should be played as if you are listening to a sledge passing by in somewhere further behind. Some people interpret it as if you are sitting in the sledge. And this is the Concertgebouw triangle. It's so precious that we try to replicate it many times to explore if it's possible to make it even better or anything close to it. And the same size, same material, same shape. Of course, it's shinier because it's new. I try to play in the same spot. The difference is very clear, and I'm quite sure it's the same for everybody. It's a very good instrument also, and it is as close as it gets, but nothing compared to what we have. Till now, even with all the technological help and analysis, it's not really possible to replicate that, so we cherish this, because once you would lose that's it, it's not possible to replicate, and you can clearly hear the orchestra if you listen to a recording, and there is a triangle popping up. You can immediately hear which orchestra is playing. If it's our triangle, then you can know that it's us. I'm gonna put this away because I'm going home and I will watch Mahler's Fourth Symphony online.